from the 15th century and onward, so many regional developed compositions based on raga appeared with ras, known as gita, simply gita. That is why we do not say the lyric of Dhrupad as Prabandha, we do not say gita. And those number of urban gitas, mainly indulged by the North Indian rulers, like the Dhruva Prabandha, Shalagosho Dhruva Prabandha, were changed into the court music Dhruvapad Prabandha and Dhruvapad court music. Nowadays, what we call Dhrupad. But we have to remember that all the Prabandhas or Padoganas were applied in the temples. That is religious song. That is the Gita. The content of the compositions are mainly based on the, what should I say, the stories on Purana, stories of God and goddesses, etc. But in the case of Dhrupad court music, composition should be elaborated. But in Prabandha, you cannot elaborate it. Songs like Rabindra Sangeet, he cannot elaborate it. You don't have Vistar. In Prabandha, Vistar was not allowed. That is elaboration. Vistar means elaboration. But in Dhrupad, it is a must. Because after performing any court music, not only Dhrupad, after performing the lyric, you will have to expand or rather elaborate with your own imagination. That is very important for the court music. However, these are the development in short. From the medieval period, I should say the last part of Sultani rule, then Mughal, then British period, the Sangeet was very much used. Sangeet includes Geetam, Badyam and Nartam. Geetam is, I have already said, about Deshi. Badyam, it is of course of four types. One is Anadha and Avanadha. In some of the texts we have seen in the modern texts that Avanadha and Anadha is the same thing, not that. Anadha means a drum instrument which is covered with skin all over, cannot be tuned, fixed even. And when it is opportunity for tuning the drum, then it is known as Avanadha. Ava means making down. That is, there are some like tabla or pakwad, etc. But not sikhol, has not the opportunity of tuning it and is a fixed tune. So sikhol is anadh, not avanadh. Folk drums are anadh. Then tatovatva, tato-stringed. Stringed instruments are to maybe plucked, maybe bowed, and there are types also. Like bow type instrument, dhanur yantra, that is known as dhanur yantra. Dhanur means bow. Like Vedic, bana. There are so many strings, not five strings of Vedic bana. It may have normally 7 to 21 strings. That was known as Mahati Ban, and three octaves were tuned in the great bow type instruments, stringed instruments. The bow type is known as Bakra and Dandobina. Dandobina means that the stem, the bina, I should say lute, and they may be fretted, may not be fretted, and it may have gold, alavu. The bina are of various types and having their different playing styles, etc. But so far we presume that mainly musical instruments were used to accompany the vocal music, not individually. But individual music playing can be found during Mughal regime. Mughal period, the solo performance were allowed in the courts also. But in public, in private institutions, we do not have any you will find any trace of solo performance. The other two classes of musical instruments are known as shushilo, that is flutes. Different types of flutes were used in India, some used for drama and some for musical performance. And ghano, that is solid. So many instruments. Of course, in shushilo, there are folk instruments, I should say classical instrument, but it can be sharply divided into two. One is for scheduled for drama, where any kind of instrument can be used, but in classical musical form, the instruments are selected. Still, you see, in Karnataka music or in North Indian music, last stage, Gitam, Vadyam, and then Nartana. Nartana means dance. It is also three types. One is nritya. In nritya, the limbs of human body are moved with rhythm, not to express any bhav. In nritya, we do not express our bhav. Simply, in folk dance, it is also nritya. When the limbs are moved to express particular mood, then it is nritya. Take the particular mood or particular any kind of any action which is expressed through our limbs is known nritya. It includes bhava. But in nritya, there is no bhava, simply moving our limbs, hands, feet, etc. No particular gesture, but because simply with the emotions we move our bodies. Natya is different thing. Natya means in a story, the actor or actresses, when they use nritya to express a particular mood or occurrence, then it will be natya. Our dance dramas are natya, which includes nritya, not nritya. Before concluding our lecture, we should know it that gaan, that is the initial part of Sangeet, and it is of two types. One is absolute, where tune is accepted without any lyric. If lyric is added in absolute music, though the words of the lyric should not have any meaning, like tarana, etc., or the bulbaris of Sitara, they are all absolute. The instrumental music is absolute music. When the tune is accompanied with lyrical words, then it is composed, and rhythm and tal composed. That is why still, even in classical music, the absolute music in the form of alap, alapti, alap. In the case of prabandha, the alap is known as alapti, and in the case of court music, like Dhrupad, etc., then before performing the composition, alap is necessary. That is, absolute music is necessary.